in Los Angeles, and I'm so excited.
Professional filmmaking can be a rewarding endeavor.
I can't even describe how excited I am.
Though not without its problems.
We're a little behind.
We just lost our location.
We're in trouble.
So over the next half hour, we'll go over some filmmaking tips to hopefully make your next film a roaring success. It's The Cutting Room Floor. Depending on who you ask, nothing makes a movie 10 times more spectacular than things falling, getting punched, blowing up, or if you're really lucky, all three at once.
Absolutely. I love the blowing up stuff.
Who doesn't? So let's get to it. Can't be too difficult, right? Let's blow something up. Show us how, Jeff Marsh, stunt coordinator for Criss Angel's Mind Freak.
You need $5 million, $10 million, $20 million insurance because you're going to blow a car up.
Well, maybe when we get a bigger budget. Now, normally this is the part where we say, but there's a cheaper, easier, low-budget way for you to do this for your beginning filmmakers. Not when it comes to explosives, my friend.
People's lives are endangered by whatever I'm doing. I do not want any, there's no piece of film worth somebody losing a finger or a part of their body.
But who knows? Maybe your mid-budget opus will get picked up for enough to fund a big-budget project with big-budget explosions. But in the meantime, put your script for Rockabilly Hoods and Fuego on the shelf and get to work on Punchageddon. Here's some tips for that.
There's a real famous punch, literally called the John Wayne. What you do is you take the punching arm flat, you put the camera there, so the arm itself blocks the hit. And I can throw a punch from here, and if he sells it at the right moment, works his head back, it looks completely real, but it only works from here.
Oh!
And you always have your guys lock eyes. If I can see his eyes, I know what he's gonna do if he can see my eyes. You guys are gonna do something. Number one, I would suggest, see if you can get a hold of somebody like me. There's several of us that are film friendly. If you can't, the best advice, leave the gaps and shoot it in order in tiny pieces. Edit your fight together. Don't do a big wide master because somebody's gonna get hurt.
And like a fine wine, nothing complements a solid fight scene, murder scene, or just about any scene like rivers upon oceans of blood.
How many of you guys shoot in black and white, just out of curiosity? A lot of you? There's an old trick, and this goes back to Orson Welles. Hershey syrup makes great blood on black and white film. Not too good in color.
But a little water and a few spoonfuls of cherry Kool-Aid is a great remedy for that. And a delicious one.
Come over. You can buy this at any good effects rental house. It's called AB Blood. You don't need a permit or anything to do with it. If you guys look, I know it's kind of hard to see. You really don't see a whole lot there. There we go, let that dry for a second. Just pretend this is a knife and I'm gonna cut the guy and put it in the A solution. Then I walk up and now I've slit his throat, he's bleeding. And that cost all maybe 10 bucks, guys.
Someone wants to do what you guys are doing when they grow up. What should they do now when they grow up?
They should study math and chemistry, and they need to start figuring out what kind of mentor do they want to work with. Find somebody, work for free.
I learn on every show.
Yeah.
Every time I do something new, because I don't want to do the same thing over and over again.
The old ways still resurface. To see young filmmakers discover these old new ways, it's kind of fun to see it.
For the 2008 Fresh Films program, the Boston, Portland, and St. Louis teams all produced action hero films, with a little help from the National Guard.
We're here to support the National Guard action hero film.
The Guardsmen advised the teens on real-life search and rescue scenarios to give their films an added dose of authenticity.
In the basement scene, you're going to have people terrified. Even your hero might stumble for a second.
If she can't feel her legs, where would it be bloody?
I'd put the blood in the face.
A lot of them even got in front of the camera. And while all of them turned in award-winning performances, there was one scene stealer from Portland that trumped them all.
We're sitting in the very back of a Black Hawk helicopter.
Chuck Norris, eat your heart out. But even in the face of extreme getting exactly what you wantitude, the Portland teens were still as resourceful as ever. To ensure safety and maximize control with the Black Hawk, a dummy replaced actor Andrew Michon for all of the helicopter lifting scenes, and all of the interiors involving Andrew were filmed on the ground with the windows overexposed, so you'd never know. In the Boston film, The Long Way Out, the story kicks into high gear after a car spins off the road during a hurricane.
Dad! Mom!
The guardsmen provided the hurricane and the downed car, but the teens provided the glue that held it all together.
We are choreographing what's going to happen when the car flips over.
You know, we could have people on this side of the vehicle give it a good little rock, you know, get it rocking pretty good, which will add to it.
A trick as old as film itself. And with the same window overexposure and a little color correction.
Stop, go!
Horrific crash, a fraction of the budget. Recap time. 1.
Safety first.
2.
Safety first.
3. If you want to become a special effects artist or do them on your own, learn, learn, learn. The old tricks are still relevant because the new ones are still evolving from the old ones. 4. When doing a fight scene as beginners, leave gaps of about a foot or more between attackers and create the fight using close-ups and camera perspective. So Punchageddon doesn't become punch a friend in the face. 5. You can make cheap blood at home with chocolate syrup, red Kool-Aid, and a little water. Just make sure all the Kool-Aid dissolves, though. Crunchy blood is a bit off-putting.
All?
And 6. As attractive as it might seem, do not attempt to blow up cars, people, or other nouns without the aid of a professional. So with that, here's some films from the 2008 Fresh Films roster that blow it up. Boston Team's The Long Way Out, and Portland Team's Surviving Emily.
Losing whatever possessions I left behind before the storm, it was worth what I found after it.
Stop, go!
I was 13, my mom left. I hate my stepmom. A week ago, a hurricane formed in the Atlantic. I didn't want to move. I could only take what was necessary, what was vital. To me, that was everything we left behind. Mary and I kind of had a falling out.
Dad, where are we?
Don't worry, Annie. It's just a shortcut I know about. We'll be able to skip the gridlock on the freeways.
Dad, how much further?
Be patient. We'll get there when we get there.
Don't worry. We're almost there. Just over a bridge.
Annie, just sit still. Look out the window or something.
Mary, there's nothing to look at. All there is darkness and rain.
Annie, I know leaving your home behind you is tough, but we didn't have a choice.
Look, you know what it's like. You barely even lived there for a year.
Hey, no need to raise our voices.
Stop, go!
Oh,
to add the rain in to keep you warm. We can take shelter in there. Let's go. Ah! Ah! I'm gonna go look for phone and supplies. Okay. Be careful. Hit by the phone! I gotta get help! Annie, your phones aren't working. I'm just glad you're okay. Annie. Oh, honey.
Mary.
I'm gonna go get help. Dad's somewhere not that far away, right? Here. Take this. Follow the road. Be careful. I'm gonna be right back, okay?
My father's great, and Mom, Mary, is good. Losing whatever possessions I left behind before the storm, it was worth what I found after it.
Operations Major Houston. How many injured? Last known location. Thank you. Sergeant Major Major Houston. Hey, we just got a SAR request from the Emergency Operations Center. Two teen, male, female, last seen location near Mount Hood. Okay. I need you to call maintenance and have them ready the first up aircraft.
Three, four, zero, four. guys, check this out.
Project Pioneer.
Okay, so we are in the foothills of Mount Hood in beautiful Oregon. We are going to, for the next 3 days, be conquering this mountain just like the pioneers did during the gold rush in the 1800s. Did you get it?
Yeah, I think we're good.
On our journey right now, the pioneers, walking.
Yeah, we were tough.
Tough.
Tough people.
Basically. Like, look around, look where we are. Garmin. We're ready. Here we are walking. Well, so far, the road we've been down. It's so hard doing a documentary.
I know, kind of rough.
Alright.
Should be near a lake soon.
You know, I don't think that thing works.
No, it definitely works. It's just maybe not getting a signal right now.
No, that's fine.
So...
Right.
So, we just need to go down that... Well, I guess we're just gonna have to go around.
That's gonna add another day, at least.
It's either that or go back. I mean, that's all we have to work with.
Okay. I don't know how you want me to do it. I'm sorry. Why don't we just stay here for the night? And we can just orient ourselves again. So today we have two choices. We can either stay put and radio for help.
Or we can try and use clues in the surroundings to figure out a way to get back on track, just like the pioneers did.
Exactly. So Tom's gonna do a little recon while I pack up camp, and I will start a fire so he can use the scent and smoke as a type of homing beacon.
So you stay at camp, I'll be back.
Let's get started.
They were definitely here. Let's get up.
Tom and Sylvia, where are you?
South side of the mountain, searched.
Last I heard, they were around House Mountain.
Sylvia, can you hear me?
another patient inside. He's off the nose at 1 o'clock.
Yeah, got him inside. All right, I got a thumbs up from the medic. I got his comp. Lowered medic.
Let's go, guys. Sylvia. We're with the Army National Guard. We're gonna get you home. Are you injured?
Yes.
Where at?
Where's Tom?
Who?
Tom.
I'm not sure. We're gonna take care of you though.
Go ahead. Yeah, we're ready for the patient education at this time.